So I don't like starting projects and then not finishing them, which is exactly what I've done with the knife. It got really hot over the summer, let's be honest here. I did not want to spend a whole lot of time in the shed. Now that it's starting to cool off, I can wrap this up. So the idea right now is to make the handle. I've got some wood that I want to use, so I just need to trace the outline of the handle, cut those into slabs, glue them on. Before I do that, I need to drill holes to hold the whole thing together, and then kind of form it up and finish it up. And then, of course, put an edge on the blade. This is going to be really tricky because I've never done this before. I know that I'm not doing this correctly. It's a really thin blade to start off with. It's a really tough steel because it was a saw. So I know that this isn't going to turn out to be a really nice knife. It's just something that I want to do. I just want to finish it and say, hey, I made a knife from a saw blade. So let's get to it. Alright, I've got the two holes drilled, and the moment of truth, the rod does fit pretty snugly too, which is perfect. There's a little bit of wiggle, but once I get the handle on and it all glued together, that'll be fine. That's not going to be an issue. At least I don't think it will. I'm going to find out. Like I said, never done this before. So the next step is to draw out the scales of the wood. I was indecisive between this black walnut and the Appetong, and I've got slates of the Appetong that are just wide enough, but I didn't like that. I didn't like not having a lot of material to work with. That plus that Appetong is really tough wood. That's going to be really hard to work with. So I think I'm going to use this section of this black walnut and this other piece, and this is left over from that end table that I made. I just kind of scavenged through the scrap bucket to find these. So I'm going to use these because they're pretty similar in texture and color. So now I need to cut out the pieces that I want and then glue it all together and let it sit overnight. It's time to glue it all together. I've got this JB Weld. It's supposed to have this little mixing nozzle. I'm gonna try it. We'll see how it goes. But the idea is I'm gonna put some glue on each side of the scales, and I've used some, I think, 60 grit sandpaper to really scuff up where the handle on the knife is so that it should have more area to bond to. So maybe it'll hold stronger. And I've gone ahead and cut my brass rods to fit. So, here we go. So I've got a little bit of a problem. I need to get up into this little curve right here, but the radius of the turn right here on the belt sander is just so that I am just barely nicking that corner of the blade, so I can't really get into this radius the way that I want to. Which sucks, because that means I have to do that by hand. Yay. But the handle's starting to look pretty good now that I've got all the epoxy off and it kind of looks more uniform. That looks really good. And I like the way that the grains right here on the top kind of meld into each other. There's two pieces of grain right here that kind of flow into two pieces over there, and just the way the grains line up here on each side, it looks really good. Got a lot of work to do right there in that little radius right there. So I got a little ahead of myself. I started cutting around this finger groove
because I know I want a groove right there for your finger, and I want this outer edge rounded over. Just trying to imagine what it's going to feel like in the hand. So I started cutting that out, and then I realized, you know, this thing is really thick. So I thought, okay, I need to stop. I need to cut off some material. So I'm going to do that with my trusty bandsaw. So I've got the finger groove all done. I've got a little bit of a nudge right here, or more of a shoulder, I guess, that I need to finish up. So just kind of looking at this as I'm talking about it. That might not be too good. There's a little bit of a curve right here that's not on the other side. So I'm just looking at this as I'm talking. Yeah, I've got to round that out right there more. But yeah, I probably should have thought about the placement of those brass pins. I don't know. It looks kind of cool to have them down in that curve, I guess. It feels good in the hand. I mean, that really just, it brings you into the front. I know I need to work on this front right here. I'm just not sure what to do or how to do that yet. I'm kind of procrastinating that part, to be honest.
Because I just don't want to have to do it.
Yeah, I'll save the hardest, most difficult, easiest to mess up part for last. That'll be a good idea. So now I need to round out this back piece. To the sander. I've made a big uh-oh. I've been talking a lot. I've only got 13 minutes left of memory, so these next few sections are probably going to be really quick. But I've got the handle done. It's not symmetrical, but that's okay. It still feels really good in the hand. I've never done this before, so I didn't know this. I was supposed to have done this part before I did the handle. So, whatever. But I've got my sandpaper here. I need to sand the blade. And I couldn't find 600, but whatever. I'm just going to have to make this work. Yeah, this will be pretty quick because, like I said, I'm running low on memory. So here we go. I'm seeing now why they say to do this before you put the handle on. That's why I have to get the masking tape there. All the shavings that come off of the blade when you're sanding mixes in with the water and makes this weird dark paste, and it was lodging up into the grains of the wood. And I don't even think that masking tape is going to help anything, because this is a sanding block is starting to look like, and it's just all those metal shavings mixing in with the water and getting into the wood. That's probably going to be a problem. So there's the first side. That's up to 1000. It's not perfect. I've got a lot to learn about this. So yep, on to the other side. There it is, all done. I did them both, well, I did each side a little bit differently. I think on this side I started with the 40 going this direction, then I used the 80 going this way, and then I did the 1000 going this way. Whereas on this side, I did each one going this way. Just to kind of style I liked better. There's not a whole lot of difference between the two styles. They both ended up looking about the same. I think I liked the way... Is it that side? No, I can't remember. I think it's this side. Whatever side where I was just going the one direction, that was way easier. So I think if I'm going to make more knives in the future, that'd be the way I go. I'm thinking about buffing it. I like the lines, but I also like a mirror finish. I think the way that it's going to end up looking, though, the lines might make it look better with the way that the handle is. So I might just leave it as is. So now I need to sharpen the edge. I need to put some oil on the handle. Just kind of start putting the finishing touches on the whole thing. So, but I mean, like I said, I messed up. I didn't think to do this part on the blade before I put the handle on, and that's really messing up the handle right here where it meets. That was just not a good idea, because there's still some lines. You can see it right there. There's some lines on the blade going parallel with the front of the handle right there that I just can't get that with the sandpaper now that I've got the handle on there. I mean, that would take a lot of time and really intricate handiwork to fix, and I just don't think it's worth it, because this is my first knife, and, you know, it's more for just to
try it out, see if I can do it. I mean, like I said, I went into this not really knowing what to do or how to do it. A lot of these projects, I just kind of jump into them feet first, you know? Which is kind of kicking me in the butt on this one, because that's a big issue. So if I were to do this again, I need to do all this before I put the handles on. And I think I might try to do this again just because I like it. I like this whole process of making a tool. I like this. It's fun. That plus I just can't find a good camping knife that has everything that I want on a camping knife, so maybe I can make my own. So yeah, at this point, I need to finish up the blade. I need to sharpen it, clean it all up, let the handle dry right there, and then put some oil on, and then it'll all be done and good to go.
All right, I've got it done, or at least mostly done. Check it out.
For the next project that I'm making, I needed a buff wheel. And that'll be exciting, because that'll be the first project where I sit down and I have everything planned out before I even start. Pretty much all these projects, I've kind of just known what I wanted to make, and I kind of knew what steps I needed to take, but I didn't have the whole thing figured out. This next project, I've got the whole thing figured out. So that'll be fun. But anyway, I've got the buff wheel. So I used a buff wheel to clean up the handle and the blade a little bit. I've already gone through and I've sanded the handle where the black spots were, at least as much as I feel comfortable doing. There's still some spots, but a lot of those, it's hard to tell if that's from the sanding process on the blade where I messed up, or if that's just discoloration in the wood. Anyway, I don't want to sand those spots any more than I already have, because it's going to mess up the way that it feels in the hand, so I don't want to touch those. I'm not sure what I'll use it for, probably just keep it on the desk for opening letters and stuff. I've got some leather working stuff. I made a wallet, but it didn't turn out the way that I wanted it to, so now I went back to my old one that's falling apart. But I've got some leather working stuff, and I probably am going to make a sheath for this at some point. So yeah, okay, I'm going to put some oil on it, and then I'll show you the finished product.
It's all done.
Check it out, man! So I put two coats of this Danish oil on. It was pretty simple. You just put a coat on, wait 15 minutes, put a coat on, wait 15 minutes, and then wipe it all off. And they have to let it set for 8 to 10 hours. And it's been like, I don't know, 20-ish? I put it on last night, but I had to work this morning, so I didn't get to do anything to it this morning. But I came home, and there it is. All done. Finally. I think if I were to redo this, I would want to use bigger pins there on the handle. I guess just for aesthetics. I mean, like I said before, I kind of want to make more knives in the future. So, we'll see how that goes. I went and got the brass rod for those pins, so I'm kind of stuck with that, I think. I don't want to have to go and buy bigger brass rods just to make a few knives, you know, so I might just keep using those. So, if they work, they work. Good learning process. You know, I learned a lot about this. I learned not to put glue across the whole surface between the scales and the blade just because it leaks out everywhere, so just kind of be more careful with that. I probably should have ground it more, at least the handle scales. I should have ground those down to the actual profile of the blade more. I think more hand sanding on the blade itself would have done good, just around, I guess, the spine of the blade. And like I said before, I've talked a lot about this, sanding the blade before I put the handle on. That would have helped a ton. That's a big learning curve there. But there it is, all done, finally. It's got an okay edge on it right now. I tried opening a letter with it and it didn't like that. So I think I need to sharpen it more, just so it'll cut into that paper better. I think, all in all, I'm happy with it. I could have done a lot worse. I could have done better, but I could have done a lot worse. That's what I think. To be honest, I'm just glad to have this thing done. I've been working on this thing for on and off a year? 9 months? 8 months? It's been a long time coming. A long time coming. So I'm just glad to finally have it done. But anyway, yep. There it is. Looks all pretty. All right, peace out. Next project coming up.